Allah says in Surah Al-Imran, chapter 3, verse 64, Ta'alu ila kalmatin sawa in bayna baynakum. Come to common terms as in us and you. Many of you may be aware of the situation in India. It's not easy to do da'wah, especially the city where I come from, Bombay. One of the most difficult places to do da'wah, according to me, it is Bombay. But Allah is the one to protect. There itself I speak. I quote the Vedas. I quote the Bhagavad Gita. I quote the Upanishads. But there, my strategy changes. There are many Indians who say, the Muslims are terrorists. This Quran, it propagates that you should fight. What kind of religious book is this? I tell them, have you read your Mahabharat? Mahabharat is one of the sacred scriptures of the Hindus. Your Mahabharat has got more verses of fighting than the Quran. If you put the Quran to shame, as far as verses of fighting is concerned. So the Hindu tells me, no, but this is a fight between truth and falsehood, haq and batil. I said, the same fight is in the Quran also. Oh, then we have no problem with the Quran. And the most commonly read scripture among the Hindu scriptures, Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita is nothing but an advice given by Shri Krishna, the God of the Hindus, to Arjun. It's mentioned Bhagavad Gita chapter number 1, verse number 43 to 46, that Arjun, in the battlefield, he puts his weapons on the ground and he says, I would prefer being killed unarmed than to fight my cousins. Mahabharata is a fight between the cousins, the Pandavas who are 5 and the Kauravas who are 100. And Bhagavad Gita is a part of Mahabharata, 25 chapters. He puts his weapon down, Arjun. Bhagavad Gita chapter number 1 verse 43 to 46. And he says, I would prefer being killed unarmed than fight my cousins. Immediately few verses after, chapter number 2, verse number 2, Shri Krishna says, O Arjun, how could such impure thoughts come in your mind? How could you be so impotent? God Almighty, Shri Krishna, is calling Arjun impotent. You will not enter the heavenly planets. You are incurring a sin. And the full Bhagavad Gita is nothing but advice given by Almighty God to Arjun that he should fight his cousins. It's further mentioned in Bhagavad Gita chapter number 2, verse number 31 to 33. That, O Arjun, you are a Kshatriya. It is your duty to fight on religious grounds. If you do not fight, you will incur sin. If you fight, you will go to the heavenly planet. And blessed are those Kshatriya who get an opportunity to fight. Imagine if I tell the Hindu, your almighty God Shri Krishna is forcing Arjun to kill his cousins. It will be devilish. What he's doing, he's telling that if you have to fight for the truth, even if you have to fight against your cousins, you have to fight. That's what the Quran says in Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 135. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, O you believe, stand out for justice as witness to the truth of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if it be against yourself, against your parents, against your relatives, whether rich or poor, Allah protects both. Same thing. And very often, a common hadith is quoted to malign Islam. Hadith of Sahih Bukhari, volume number 4, in the book of Jihad, chapter number 2, hadith number 45. And the critics, they quote, your prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he said that if a mujahid is killed in the battlefield, he will go to heaven. If he comes back alive, he gets the wealth of this world. And even the critics of India, like Arun Shuri, they quote this hadith against Islam. I tell them, haven't you read the Bhagavad Gita? Bhagavad Gita says in chapter number 2, verse number 37, Shri Krishna, the God of the Hindu, he is telling Arjun that, O Arjun, go and fight. If you are killed, you will go to the heavenly planets. You will go to Swarg. You will go to heaven, to paradise. If you come back alive, you will get the booty of this war. Verbatim translation of Sahih Bukhari. Verbatim. I tell these Hindus that haven't you read your own scripture, you want to take out false in the Quran and the Hadith? Based on the guidance given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ta'ala ila kalmatin sawa'in bayna bainakum. Come to common terms as us and you.